श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हरि ओम टू एवरीबॉडी वी आर ऑन दी लास्ट लेग ऑफ दी आउटपोरिंग्स डे फ्रेश डे We were reminded that our prayer should be intense so that we ensure that all our thoughts, words and deeds are in conformity with the Lord's will. Specifically, Papa's prayer. We will again read that very important, very, very important. O Ram, Ramdas is thy slave, thy entire slave. He implores thee to strictly watch every act he performs, every word that falls from his lips, every thought that comes to his mind. O Ram, see that nothing unworthy of thee or unacceptable to thee be done, talked or thought of by thy slave. Let Ramdas's actions be always right and good. Let his speech be always wise and gentle. Let his thoughts be always holy and pure. In short, let Ramdas's acts, words and thoughts emanate directly from the meditation of thy divine self. So it's the toughest order for all of us, I agree. But we keep on trying, you know. Papa is giving us clues. Next one also, see that. O Ram, what a glorious being thou art. Ramdas lays his head at thy holy feet, deign to shed thy full lustre on thy slave. Make him thine totally. Ramdas has no refuge but thee, no parent but thee, no guide but thee, no master but thee. No higher ideal than thee. Have mercy on him, O Ram. Have mercy. Above all, O Ram, see that he does not forget thee. To forget thee means for him utter ruin. Ramdas cannot bear the very thought of it. O Ram, Ramdas has full trust in thee. He knows that what Ramdas begs, thou grantest at once. Let him always live in thee alone, Om Shri Ram. We can take it that at the time of chanting Ramnam, at the time of doing bhajan or hearing bhajan, part of the mind must be on this. Even while hearing, you have facilitated me to hear this. Though you have dropped the body many, 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 many decades ago, today you have facilitated me to hear your own words. I take it that it is a gentle reminder to us, though we have been claiming that you are devotees, we have been doing sadhana as defined by us. We still feel the nearness has not been felt. So somehow make us to do that. Only when we have started knowing the and feeling the nearness, we can place all our body, mind, intellect at your holy feet. If we still feel you are far away, then to that extent the distance is there. The next one, O Ram, save thy child. Let every fiber of his being thrill to the music of thy madness. The very blood of his veins rush impelled by the fury of thy madness. His very bones tatter and shatter in their seeds by the repeated blows inflicted by thy madness. His whole frame quiver, tremble, shake by letting fall on him an avalanche of thy madness, Om Shri Ram. The body, you know. Rise, O Ramdas, there we stop. Fly above all, soar in the heavens, mingle in the flood of light poured down by the glorious sun. Let the pure, rarefied air above encircle you all around. Let space itself swallow you up. Where are you then, Ramdas? Ramdas is nowhere. Ramdas is now mere madness, an airy thing. Truth, the great truth, Ram has devoured you. And you are no more, Om Shri Ram. When we hear this, you know, two Mahatma's life come before our mind. One is Sri Sri Ramalingadigal of Tamil Nadu. We have been told that at the end he dematerialized himself. The other one was, you know, Mataji's Apriya Samarth. When he finally went inside, nothing was there. After some hours, when they opened. So when you say devoured, you know, it can happen in so many forms.
Same thing with the Nandanar also?
Nandanar, when he, with all that, you know, excitement, when he went, he ran. And he became one with, as soon as the Nataraja Vigraha was seen, people saw him going in, but then not a trace of it.
The void, the diamond, there is only one void, the great void, perhaps.
It can also happen, or direct term. We We had a friend, I think we have shared this. He became a Swami. And then he used to come to Ayanar. He also come here. He was staying in Chathamangalam, near the engineering college. One day we were told, you know, the neighboring people, they smelled something, and the person who used to bring the milk, suddenly they saw the door is still closed. So finally, curiosity developed, everybody came, they somehow called him, there was no response, so broke open the door and then went inside. There, you know, they saw a havan and they charred the body. He himself offered. Whether there was a havan or he himself generated the heat, we don't know. That was in late 90s, early 2000. So devouring, no? That means this the separate entity, I as a separate entity does not exist. So it will be difficult for us to conceive of that state because we are still within the limitation of the body, mind, intellect. So at best we can say the feeling of me and mine completely gets rooted out. The final stage of the four steps, becoming one with, where you lose all distinctions. You remember at the beginning when you are defining Ram, who is Ram? He says, he is present in all things and in all creatures who only appear as separate entities due to their ever-changing forms. So that he has realized. Again we proceed. O Ramdas, become one with the greenness of the leaves. We absorb the splendor of light, mix with the mist of the hills, be the breath of the wind, the blue of the sky, the golden hues of the dawn, the stillness of the night. Om Shri Ram. Again, some more practical clues. How to still the mind, you know. Greenness of the leaves. In our case, it is only for a fraction of a second, but we all enjoy that. Different types of leaves, different types of plant kingdom. Suddenly we are attracted, you know. Suppose it stays for some time, what will happen? Similarly, we absorb the splendor of light, mix with the mist of the hills. We all look at it, you know. Just to think about it, you know, what happens in our mind. Unknowingly, the stillness develops. Be the breath of the wind. Be the blue of the sky. The golden hues of the dawn. And finally, the stills of the night. Terrace. Of course, in cities there will be light. Agreed. But after 10 o'clock or 10:30, you will find, you know, the stillness. In village area, it is very easy. After 9 o'clock, you will find 7:30, 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock. So as sadhakas, we suddenly become aware so many things are before me, gateway to the stillness. I have never attempted. I used to feel and say, I enjoy, that's all. For a fraction of a second we all get that, but we don't feel like retaining it. We never thought that it has something to do with our spiritual journey. We thought it was a nice thing for the eyes to see or the thought to feel. We never connected up that it is all the expression of the spirit, expression of divinity. Now we shall try. O Ram, thou art kindness, thou art love, thou art the great truth. Let Ramdas cling to thee fast. Let him not lose his hold on thee. Let him always clasp thee firmly. Let him always live with thee. Let him always live in him, in thee. Let him not be separated from thee. Let him always remain in thy embrace, O Ram. Enfold thy slave always in thy arms, never let him go. Make him fearless, bold and firm, firm in his vows, firm in his faith in thee. Let contact with the world not affect him. Ramdas, always remember that you are alone in the world in the company of Ram. So when we try for the inner communion, this will all help a lot. Supplications, you know, or prayers. Please, you know, through how many sentences, you know, he pleads to be in the fond embrace of the Lord. Let Ramdas cling to be fast. Let him not lose his hold on thee by looking here and there, you know, attracted by this and that. Let him not. Exclusive. Let him always live with thee in thee. Let him not be separated from thee. Suppose early morning after we get up, you know, when we are not disturbed by any other thought, by any other person, any other situation, any other object, suppose we quietly read these lines and sit there. Hundred % sure there will be an ecstatic feeling, ecstatic experience. If it is difficult to have this relationship in the abstract form, we can give any form, you know. Let him not be separated from thee, let him always remain in thy embrace, O Ram. Enfold thy slave always in thy arms. Never let him go. I may try to go out of you, but never let permit me to go out. make him fearless, bold and firm. Firm in his vows. Firm in his faith. Let contact with the world not affect him. Likes and dislikes, you know, so many preference, priorities, all these come only when I contact with somebody. I cannot avoid, but let it not affect me. So internally, if I get rooted in you, I will not be affected. Ramdas, always remember that you are alone in the world in the company of Ram. Next one. Ramdas, in spite of Ram's unbounded grace upon you, you are still weak. Ramdas, you are still small and insignificant, full of imperfections, full of defects. Bah. Cry, cry, weep, weep. Oh Ramdas, cry and weep. Yeah. Why are you bringing all these words so far? We cannot understand. We have not found any so far. At least academically we will know, you know. Suppose you slip somewhere, you lose your temper, you are attracted, some temptation. Grass, from the grass level. Now when we say that, we take it, because you are also a votary of truth. You will not say something which is untrue. So that means this should be a subtle feeling.
I am talking, then it is true only. Maybe it is for us, if it is for us. I am full of weak, full of that, then you can say, as you say. Assume yourself as talking.
Ramdas, you are still small and insignificant, full of imperfection, full of defects. Cry, cry, weep, weep, Ramdas, cry and weep, take off, O Ram, all is egoism. So that means the sense of individuality, ego, though purified to a very, 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 very great extent, still have its hold, you know. The leeches, I don't know whether you have seen, it will be like this.
Yes.
One hole will be there.
Yes.
Otherwise it will not raise.
Yes.
99.99 of its body is not there on your body.
Mm-hmm.
Only a small, tiny thing. So similarly, this sense of individuality, though at the gross level it is not there, it might be still there in some form. That's the same you would have mentioned. So that means, for us, you know, it's a big, big, big boulder. Not insignificant. So now the warning is that even the impurities at the subtle levels, the other day we were sharing Vinobaji's, you know, muddy water, when it is kept for some time, all the muddy substance, you know, it gets settled down at the bottom, and the upper portion will become pure water. But the moment you put a stick or something gets disturbed at the bottom, which is not visible, suddenly you find the dirt comes at the top, surface level. This is what happens to us now. Because of our various practices, we may be becoming sattvic, or you know what you call it. We may be feeling that we are sattvic. We may be feeling that we are progressing on the spiritual. First of all, we think we are all spiritual aspirants. We may be feeling that there is some progress in our this thing. But when somebody touches you, you know, finished. Somebody blames you for not or for no fault of you. Immediately you flare up. So that means the me and mine is, what is that word of Papa? Crystallized selfishness. Rama, 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 Rama. it's a great pointer. Ramdas, in spite of Ram's unbounded grace upon you are still weak, Ramdas. You are still small and insignificant, full of imperfection, full of defects. Cry, cry, weep, weep. O Ramdas, cry and weep. Take off, O Ram, all his egoism. So when we start viewing ourselves as a third person, then only we can some understanding we will have. And the next one is that now we ourselves are making that conflagration. Just like we told you, the Swami who offered his body to the Homa. O Ram, raise a great conflagration, a mighty deluge of fire. Burn up in its devouring flames all the evils that are in Ramdas. The fire is lit. Flames are rising. Red tongues of fire, flame, waving, hissing, dancing. Throw in now, by Ram's command, O Ramdas, first Ahankar, then Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya, in quick succession. As if you know it is like this. Right, they are all in now. Fan the flames. O Ram, all the evils are burning, burning, burning. Now they fly as smoke, they fall as ashes. All glory to thee. O Ram, now the fire ceases. A calm prevails. Stillness of heavenly repose. Filled with the enchantment of love and peace. Filled with the sweetness of Ram. Freedom, freedom, freedom. Mukti is thy name, O Sri Ram. So mentally we enact this.
Being burnt into ashes.
Somewhere in Ramdas' poem, Papa used to say, you should stand on the ashes of your own cremated ego. Now we understand what is cremated ego. So every day we have to do our own cremation, na? So mentally we visualize the havan and we know all these are there. Mentally we take, again may come and stick in our case. But it is worth trying. This enactment is worth trying. So that is why first he said you are weak, you are full of imperfections. Then he doesn't leave like that. There is a method by which we can purify. So he says, O Ram, what a glorious being thou art. O Ram, raise a great conflagration, a mighty deluge of fire.
Deluge of fire.
And burn up its devouring flames. Chapter. All the evil that are in Ramdas. The fire is lit. The flames are rising. Red tongues of flame. Waving, hissing, dancing. That we must see that, no? Throw in now by Ram's command. O Ramdas, first Ahankar. Then Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya. In quick succession. Right, they are now in it. Fan the flames until it is completely burnt. O Ram, all the evils are burning, burning, burning. Now they fly as smoke, they fall as ashes. All glory to thee, O Ram. Now the fire ceases. Then a calm prevails. Stillness of heavenly repose, filled with the enchantment of love and peace, filled with the sweetness of Ram. Freedom, freedom, freedom. Mukti is thy name, O Sri Ram. So when this is done, the next one, no, this should be done, I think read in that order. Mentally we have to travel with him. We have to do what all we did. Then only the real sweetness can come. Not reading, not hearing. O Ram, thy slave is under thy protection completely. Thou art his sole refuge. He looks to thee for everything. At all times let thy sweet name be in his thoughts. O Ram, purify Ramdas's mind. Purge it off from all evil and unworthy thoughts. O Ram, Ramdas is thine. Bear in mind, Ramdas, you live only for Ram. Bah, what a... In film shooting we can see, you know, action, action, like this. They say, he will act, he will act. Similarly, you know, such person. He says, O Ram, then O Ramdas, you know. O Ram, purify Ramdas's mind. Purge it off from all evil. O Ram, Ramdas is thine, bear in mind. Ramdas, you live only for Ram. You do not live for anything else or anybody else. Ram is the end and aim of your existence. Your very life is bound up with Ram. O Ram, make Ramdas's faith in thee ever unshakable, ever firm, permanently fixed. Let all Ramdas's thoughts, acts, words proceed directly from thee, at thy bidding, in thy name, for thy sake. Let Ramdas's personality merge itself in thee. Make him thy abode. Make thee his abode. One in the other always intermingled. Let there not be a moment separation. Blended, welded together forever and ever. Powerful as thou art, O Ram. Love as thou art, O Ram. Light as thou art, Ram. Bliss as thou art. The great, the only truth thou art. Thy slave prays to thee, begs thee, implores thee, cries to thee, weeps to thee, prostrates before thee, O Ram. Have pity on thy slave. Make him thine altogether. Ram, bless thy slave. To bless thy slave is to bless the world. To love thy slave is to love the world. O Ram, O love infinite, enter into the very being of Ramdas and live there and spread thy light, love and bliss. Om Shri Ram. Bah. How the welding takes place, you know. Blending takes place. He is ensuring, you know, not by one expression, not by two, not by three, a procession of expressions, you know. Mind has no interval to think about anything else. O Ram, there is a dawn, a brilliant dawn in the heart of Ramdas. There is in it a flood of light, a flash of love, rush of bliss. Purity dwells where Ram is. He enters, all evils flee. The sun rises, all darkness vanishes. O Ram, how glorious thou art. The moment thou art appealed to, thou listenest. Thou grantest, O Mother, how kind of thee, how beautiful is thy love, how tender, how soft, how gracious, how true, how bracing, how cooling, how good, oh, how lasting. O Ram, thine is thy slave, thine is thy slave, thy child, forever, forever, forever. Om, 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 Om Shri Ram. Higher and higher the thought rises until it is lost in the incomprehensible. Deeper and deeper the thought runs down until it is lost in the unfathomable. Wider and wider the thoughts press out until it is lost in the unexplorable. Narrower and narrower the thought contracts until it is lost in the unthinkable. Om Shri Ram. Superlative degree of every such moment, you know, ultimately fusions in becoming one with. Higher and higher the thought rises until it is lost in the incomprehensible. Deeper and deeper the thought runs down until it is lost in the unfathomable. Wider and wider the thought spreads out until it is lost in the unexplorable. Narrow and narrower the thought contracts until it is lost in the unthinkable. Om Shri Ram. The inward journey, you know. Inward journey finally resting in the stillness. Probably we can try to understand by higher and higher and higher up, no? Only up to some stage we can say, then we cannot say that, because it is limitless. Deeper and deeper and deeper, again it is depthless. Wider and wider and wider, it is, it has no circumference. So from the finite to the infinity, you know? From the limited to the unlimited, from me to him, from the micro to the macro. So these are all, you know, the realms of experience of inward journey. So beautiful clues here, you know, I am. Whichever way you can try. And the last one. Love expands the heart and hate contracts it. There is nothing sweeter than love. There is nothing more bitter than hate. Love is natural. Hate is unnatural. Love makes, hate destroys. Love is charming, charming and cooling landscape. Hate is arid and cheerless desert. Love is harmony, hate is chaos. Love is light, hate is darkness. Love is bliss, hate is misery. Love is life, hate is death. Love is purity, hate is impurity. Love combines, hate breaks up. Love is beauty, hate is ugliness. Love is hell. Hate is disease. Love is sweet music. Hate is discordant noise. Love is wisdom. Hate is ignorance. Love is activity. Hate is dullness. Love is heaven. Hate is hell. Love is God. Hate is illusion. Om Shri Ram. Different ways of expression and different assertions that we should be alert not to become a prey in the hands of hate. clear-cut definition will definitely help us. Before the mind comes out and justifies, we must assert these words. For every act, the mind justifies its action based upon the rights and wrongs it has already fixed. So here Papa is probably asking us, keep on thinking about the positive side. Whatever opposite is there for the positive side is that to be avoided. Alertness. We saw day for yesterday, you know, Vinobaji is that letter, destroying the letter of Bapuji. It's because of the alertness. When he was pushed to the corner by his shishya, finally he said, ultimately to keep this, you know, it will only help the ego. That much alertness. No matter from where the letter comes, where the appreciation comes, he is riveted to this. Just now we read, you know, true to the vows we have taken. Very clear that we all want to become zero. The end and aim of all spiritual discipline is to become a weak zero, not to become something. Now we know why he drafted this universal prayer. No? The essence of all these are there. O Lord of the universe, O creator, protector and destroyer of the world, I come in all humility to thy holy feet, surrender myself entirely to thee, deign to bless me ever with thy remembrance. O merciful divine master, give me strength, purity and peace. Thou art seated in the hearts of all. Thou art all goodness, all love. Thou art a veritable ocean of peace and bliss. Thou art the lover of thy devotees, refuge of the helpless, redeemer and savior of those who resign themselves to thee. Make me dedicate my life to thee and to thy service. By thy grace may peace and joy always dwell in my heart. Thou art mother, master, friend and all to me. Accept me as thy child and servant. Grant me power to love thee with all my heart. Let whatever I do be a fitting offering at thy holy feet. Make me pure in thought, word and deed. I lay my mind at thy feet, fill it always with thy remembrance. Let thy glorious light illumine my heart. O sustainer of the world, O kind and compassionate Lord, God of gods, give me the divine vision, so that I may behold thee in all as all. Make me ever feel thy constant fellowship. May my life be guided and controlled by thee. Thy presence be ever with me, in me, and everywhere around me. I beg of thee, I prostrate before thee, hearken to this heartfelt prayer of mine. Make me thine and thine only, forever and ever. Make me thine and thine only, forever and ever. Make me thine and thine only, forever and ever. So the utterance of the prayer should touch and kindle this emotion, you know. It should be repeated with this feeling. So that is the quintessence of all the outpourings we can see. We can take lessons, so many lessons. One of the lessons is there should be solitude, there should be a communion with Him. We should place everything before Him. Seek His intervention. Every now and then look at us. In the act of glorifying God, we may forget to look at us. And then we know the limitations it has. Then devise an exercise by which, you know, we are throwing out. And again, then after throwing out, completely wiping it out, what is the feeling that we develop? And then again, when we have enjoyed that, we again plead, please don't leave me. I find myself totally safe in your hand. Never be away from me. I can't do it. You have to hold me. So with these words, the is over, and then one poem. O man, where is sweetness? It is in thee. Where is bitterness? It is in thee. It is all comprehensive. Sugar cane is brought. A bitter God is. Do we blame bitter God? Think. Where is sweetness? It is in thee. Where is bitterness? It is in thee. Where is happiness? It is in thee. Where is misery? It is in thee. Where is light? It is in thee. Where is darkness? It is in thee. Where is love? It is in thee. Where is hate? It is in thee. Where is heat? It is in thee. Where is cold? It is in thee. Where is good? It is in thee. Where is evil? It is in thee. Where is truth? It is in thee. Where is untruth? It is in thee. Where is wisdom? It is in thee. Where is ignorance? It is in thee. Where is heaven? It is in thee. Where is hell? It is in thee. Where is good? It is in thee. Where is God? It is in thee. Where is illusion? It is in thee. Ram is a reservoir of nectar, composed of light, love and bliss. Papa is often charmed with these three words. Love, light and bliss. Light, love and bliss. So we take it, light stands for awareness, love stands for absence of otherness, bliss stands for fullness. Ram is a reservoir of nectar composed of light, love and bliss. O Ramdas, dive into this well of ambrosia, sink, swim, dance, nay, drown yourself in it. Ram is a volume of fragrance made up of light, love and bliss. O Ramdas, merge into this wave of aroma. Dive, play, gamble, nay, lose thyself in it. Om Shri Ram. Ram is a rainbow of colors formed of light, love and bliss. O Ramdas, gaze into this heaven of tints. Link, soak, blend, nay, feel thyself one with it. Om Shri Ram. Ram is a music of tunes filled with light, love and bliss. O Ramdas, drink at the fountain of thrills. Reel, shake, wake, nay, die in the intoxication of it. Om Shri Ram. So this, we don't know how many days you are having these outpourings. The state of outpouring, we did not know how many days yet. Practically, has not given us any clue about it. So we take it now. When Puja Mataji wanted us to read this 11 at a stretch for 11 days, we get a comprehensive idea of the whole thing. Whatever I have left in the first, I can make up in the second. Again, whatever I have left in the second, I can make up. So by the time I reach the 11th, an overall picture of the whole spiritual journey of Papa. And at the end of this outpouring, when we remove the word Ramdas and Fiddlers with it, we know exactly now. Where are we now? What are we to do now? Ultimately, what I should become. The last line is this. Ram is a reservoir of nectar composed of light, love and bliss, awareness, absence of otherness, no separateness. I don't exist as a separate entity. Awareness absolute, consciousness absolute. Light, you all remember, no? The talk between, who is that?
Yajnavalkyan
Janaka. Finally, the light is shown here, no? By whose light, you know, keeps on telling. So ultimately, it is the awareness, the knowing principle in us. Love means absence of otherness. And bliss means fullness. Om Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnad, Purnamaduchade, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnameva Avashishyate. So love, light, love and bliss. Ram is a nectar. Ram is a reservoir of nectar composed of light, love and bliss. What am I to do? O Ramdas, dive into this well of ambrosia. Sing, swim, dance. Nay, drown thyself in it. Become one with it. Ram is a volume of fragrance made up of light, love and bliss. Ramdas, merge. O Ramdas, merge into this wave of aroma. Dive, play, gambol. Nay, lose thyself in it. Om Shri Ram. Ram is a rainbow of colors. Formed of light, love and bliss. O Ramdas, gaze into the heaven of tints, link, soak, blend. Nay, feel thyself one with it. Ram is a music of tunes filled with light, love and bliss. O Ramdas, drink at this fountain of thrills. Reel, shake, wake. Nay, die in the intoxication of it. Om Shri Ram. That is how he concludes this. Then a few poems.
The deluge of flame.
And the letter of Gurudev that we will take it up there tomorrow.
The deluge of flame.
When we take up this 11 times reading, some jotting down is necessary, we feel. After the 37th chapter is over, where we all list out the tests meted out to him, we can also jot down what stands before us while we read this. Not that everything should go into one is enough. That one is expressed in so many pages, that's all. Final message is the extinction of the sense of individuality, you know. The truth is, he is making us to think, do, talk. And we feel we are thinking, we are talking, we are doing. So the diagnosis has been now made. So we devise, you know, some treatment by which we drive out the disease and we become our old self. So this portion is equally important, you know, for a sadhaka. Not only these 37 chapters, the beginning with that introduction of Ram, you know, O love, O truth, O goal of human perfection, from that, you know, it starts. And then the 37 chapters. First two or three chapters is the preparation. It contains lot of hints for us. And from the fourth onwards, we are being tested. And after the 37 tests, one after, every time Papa passes the test, cheerfully passes the test, without grumbling, without complaint, without frustration, without anxiety, without uncertainty. Always blissful. And then comes back, settles down. And then the final, what do you call this, you know, when you make the sculpture, or when you, finishing touch, yeah. The finishing touch. We can say that these outpourings are probably the things which we don't know from the outer level. So he says, all these are okay, tests are okay, I have passed, so what? Still there are things to be removed, to be purified, to be got rid of. Yes, yes. The sadhaka, we should be alert. He should never take it as granted that he has reached any stage. Unless and until he wipes out the entire thing which is there, the subtlest form. Which only we know. Nobody can know this, you know. Even we may not know. There is a beautiful article by Chidanji Maharaj. There he will say, probably you may also know. He knows the deficiencies. Yes, after tomorrow we will read it out also. Where am I? The sadhaka and the sadhana, no, in this. What is the sadhana doing to me? Am I becoming a better person? So some more, you know, clues he has given. There he says this. So Papa is facilitating us to think in those terms. So inquest of God does not end. Inquest of God will end only when the seeker is merged in the thought. So long as there is a seeker, the journey is on. So the touchstone is, when the fullness is there, no more questions, you know. Light, love and bliss. When we reach that, when we plunge into ourselves, into that, Papa clearly indicates that is the final one. And this will be known only to that individual. And it will be difficult for him to put it in words. Because it is past expression. For so many days he has been taking. So according to Mataji, we have done the first reading. We have completed the first reading. Like this, it should be 11 times reading. If it has to be done like that, it will take 2-3 years, you know?
Yes.
So, day after tomorrow, we will officially see that this is completed, but it is not completed. Because it happens to be a book, in the form of a book, we can say that is the final portion, that's all. But the theme is a continual process. That we have now realized. We can never say, in quest of God, yes, I have already. No.
Don't mean the word completed.
Never. When the Bhagavata Satsanga is conducted, or even our Hari Rama Satsanga, you will find that on the last day, they will again start.
Yes.
Because only the performance is close, that's all. The Lord is ever living. So you cannot say that in 7 days I have completed the glories of the Lord. He is ever present reality. So for that, you know, symbolically, they will again restart with the same slogan.
So the same thing with our Arthi, also daily food, what we are doing in the Banahar. We go to the building, again starting with the Ramna. That is ending and starting also. That is how it will start.
Yeah.
Every time, every day, there is no end. It is supposed to be continuous.
There is no closing. There is no closing.
No closing.
So this from Hyderabad and Andhra Pradesh, so many people used to come here regularly for Hare Rama. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. 7 days, day and night, they will have some clusters, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 people. And they will come and sit and do for 2 hours. And they have 2 sessions will be there for one group. And the 7th day, when they have completed this, we all share, everybody will again assemble. On the beginning everybody will assemble. And at the end also we all assemble. They will close it not only with Hare Rama. They will have Ramnam, they will have some bhajan. Hanuman Charisa, so many things. And then they will say, we will start again. Then again Hare Rama for a few minutes. So that it is again started. Now we understand the significance of it. So here also on the 31st December night, we used to say the year goes with Ramna and the New Year starts with Ramana. So that the link is unbroken. Suppose we all retire to bed on 31st. Unknowingly tomorrow morning Happy New Year, we will say that, no? As if there is no connection. But in order that there is an inner connection, eternal connection, on 31st December till 12 o'clock, Dham Nam goes on. And exactly at 12, we stop. And then some messages of Papa we will read. And again our prayer. And then again we start Dham Nam. And then only after 12:30 or 12:30, we disperse. So that the year is also started with Dham Nam. So similarly, it is continuous, you know. It is non-stop. So our inquest of God, until we cease to become an individual, inquest of God continues. In that journey, the first few kilometers or first few meters we would have now gone. It's a long, 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 long journey. So we have just finished, we will again restart. Each one can devise their own methods. When you take up, one more sankalpa is slowly brewing, we don't know how far the fire is going to facilitate. In line with what he has been giving us for the past now a couple of months, if possible, if the statute agrees, permits, in December we will have a IQG, Inquest of God, 11 times reading, individually by participants, and every day we will have a common satsang to take up some, to highlight some of the points raised in it. For the 11 days again, we relive those moments. But there will be an individually you will read, not that somebody will read, somebody will hear. Individually everybody reads, individual sadhana is there. And then we will also meet collectively. And at that time, everybody will be able to mentally associate completely with that particular portion which we have covered. Even in one day's reading, we will ensure that two or three chapters are intensely gone through. And then it will be followed by a common satsang, bhajan. Ramnam, of course, will be there. Ramnam that is going on in bhajan hall as well as in Samadhi Mandir. So, this is the sankalpa Papa is just giving. We are only not very clear what we will do if the quarantine is imposed, but it looks as though it will be lifted by that time, and we will have some restrictions among ourselves, that's all. Because now state to state movement also has been freed. Previously we have taken e-pass. So today morning paper clearly indicates it is from September 1st or something. 7th.
No, somewhere
I saw September 3rd. September 1st, somewhere. Anyway, that we will clarify. So from September beginning onwards, this e-pass business will not be there. When e-pass business is not there, and if there is no recording at the boundaries, probably we hope and pray that the government may ask us to protect ourselves, devise our own methods, rather than imposing it. If that is the case, then we will do that. With mask, with the social distancing.
Then quarantine may not be there.
Quarantine in the present form may not be there.
Self-quarantine.
So the...
They may not insist on
it. Something like that. Let us see.
No.
So if that is going to be a reality, then the end of December, we all will have individual and collective sadhana on in quest of God. We hope and pray. So that, just like, we need something to get riveted with us, you know. That screws, and then we put it, you know, then it won't go away. So the some of the themes contained in the In Quest of God must go deep into us, so that when we start 2021, we must be armored with this, insulated with this. And by the this 21-22 we should try this, and 22 December 27th 1922 happens to be the centenary day of how this In Quest of God book came into being. Papa is slowly taking us to that particular memorable day, 27th December 1922. So we will say 27th December 2022. So for stock taking, he gives us 2 years' time now. Anyway, that's all some thoughts he gave. So let us all try to make use of the present facilities, and somehow it is not how we arrange, what we arrange. What is more important is to what extent the theme gets rooted in us. In the vision for September, October, November, probably December, it will all contain now only on this IQG. So when we go through that simultaneously, many points which need some amplification, it will get amplified. Some whatever we have shared, you know, in some form it is touched. Most of the words are from Papa only, so it is an addition, it's a boost to us. So kindly go through it very often. Right from July, August, you can see a great void, you know. Then September, it has just been published. It will go for posting. What to look for, some portions while reading, what are the points to look for. 8 points have been covered in September issue.
No, October issue. 8 points are in October issue. 8 points are in October issue. 8 points in October issue.
September we have covered 8 points. September is coming, you know. September we have covered, you know.
This is
8.
October.
Oh, sorry. August. Oh, sorry. In September issue.
General.
August issue and September issue covered general.
General.
September issue covered general about in Quest of God. October issue covered 8 points that will be looked for. Balance 8 will be covered in November.
Yes, in December.
And December, we don't know. December, January it will take,
yes,
to cover some of the important. December it will cover some of the important tests meted out to Papa. So in the next 3 months, we will be associating with Papa's experience narrated in Inquest of God. By highlighting, by concentrating on some points. Because we don't want this to evaporate just like that, no? Immediately after this session, everything gets evaporated. We are back to square one. No. So the September, October, November, December issues, which will keep it, you know, keep our mind fully engaged on In Quest of God. The different facets, different approaches, different types of episodes, different points, different views. Yeah, it will, I think it will go to January also because there's a outpourings have to be touched.
I think it will go for 6 months now.
Anyway, for the next 6 months.
There's no end.
No.
It is not going to be ended.
Oh, it's already 4:45. I'm sorry. Hariom, 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 Hariom. Nobody reminds or comes and says, enough is enough. Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram
Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai
Hariom, Hariom.